This is the question asked in today's SkillRack daily challenge. In the first line of our input, we are given the value of F. So the value of F is the number of food items available. So here F is equal to 4. So we are given 4 dishes as input. So the first dish is idli and its calories is 150. The second dish is dosa and its calories is 200. So like this, another 2 more dishes, vada and pongal, are given. So after accepting the dishes and their calories, we are given the value of n. So the value of n is the number of customers. So here it is 6. So we are given 6 lines of input. And in every line, the first string denotes the name of the customer, and then the next string denotes the dishes consumed by the customer. So the first customer name is PQR and he has had idli, dosa and vada. And the second customer is DEF and he ate pongal. So like this, we are given 6 customers' name and the dishes that they consumed. So in every line, I have calculated the calories consumed by the customer. So the first customer PQR has taken idli, dosa and vada. And the calories of idli plus dosa plus vada is equal to 450. So the total calories consumed by PQR is 450. So I have written it here. And then DEF has eaten only pongal. So the calories in pongal is 300. And we are also writing the number of dishes. So PQR has taken 3 dishes and the total calories is 450 and it is of 3 dishes. And DEF has taken only 1 dish and its calories is 300. And then GHI has taken 2 dishes of total 250 calories. So like this, the integers inside the bracket is the total number of dishes consumed by every person. Now let us write the name of customers in descending order based upon the calories consumed by them. So the most calories is consumed by M and O. So he has consumed 500 calories. So let us write M and O first. And then next 450 is the next smallest value. So 450 calories are consumed by 3 people. So PQR has consumed 450 and ABC has consumed 450 and JKL. So now let us write it randomly. So first PQR and then next ABC and then JKL. So they have consumed 450 and the next smallest is 300. So DEF has consumed 300 calories. And now finally the customer GHI has consumed only 250 calories. So GHI. Now we have sorted the name of customers based upon the total calories they have consumed. But here the customers PQR, ABC and JKL has consumed same number of calories. So whenever the calories consumed by the customers are same, then we have to sort them based upon the number of dishes they have consumed. So PQR has consumed 3 dishes, ABC has consumed 2 dishes and JKL has consumed 3 dishes. So PQR and JKL has consumed 3 dishes and ABC has consumed only 2 dishes. So when we sort this in descending order, the name of ABC goes below JKL because all the 3 has consumed 450 calories, but PQR and JQL has consumed 3 dishes and ABC has consumed only 2 dishes. So the name of ABC goes down. But now still PQR and JKL are not sorted because they have consumed same number of calories and they have also consumed same number of dishes. So in this case, so whenever the calories consumed and the total number of dishes are also equal, then we have to sort the customer name based upon their name. So whenever the total calories consumed and the number of dishes consumed are also same, then we have to sort the customers based upon their name. So we should sort this customer PQR and JKL based upon their name. So the character J occurs first. So JKL's name will be first, and after that only PQR's name will be present. So now all the customers' names are sorted as per the conditions given in the question. So let us check it with our output. So the first customer is MNO JKL PQR. So MNO JKL PQR and then ABC DEF GHI. So ABC DEF GHI. So this is how we are sorting the name of customers. Now let us see how to write a C program for this. To solve this problem, first we will be creating two arrays named food items and calories. So we will be storing the food items separately and the calories of it separately. And after accepting the food items, we will accept the customer names. So while accepting our customer names, we will store the name of our customer in a separate character array named names, and then we will store the total calories consumed by the customer in a separate array named total calories. So we will accept this string completely as an input and split this string based upon the commas present in between this string and search each dishes. So first we will search the calories of idlis, and we will search the calories of dosa, and we will search the calories of vada, and add all the calories and store it in the integer array named total calories. So we will do this operation simultaneously while accepting the input itself. So now let us go to our code. So first I am including the header file string.h, because in our program we will be using strtok, which will come under string.h. So first, after including the header file, I am creating two functions named swap and swapch. So the first function swaps two integers. So it accepts two integers in its arguments and interchanges their values. And this function swapch accepts two character array in its arguments and swaps them. So to swap, first we will create a new temporary character array, and then we will store A into the character array temp, and then we will replace A with B, and then we will store temp into B. So when we do like this, both the character arrays will be swapped. So now let us start with our main function. So first I am creating two integers named f and n, and the next line I am accepting the value of f, and then I am creating a character array named food items of size f, and in every index we can store up to 50 characters, and then I am creating an integer array named calories which is of size f. So we will accept the food items and their respective calories. So to do that, first I am creating a for loop that iterates from 0 to f, and in every iteration I am accepting the food name and its calories and storing it into the array food items and calories. So after the execution of this for loop, we would have accepted the food items and their respective calories. Now we have to accept the customers. So the number of customers is the value n. So in the next line, I am accepting the integer n as input, and then I am creating a character array named name of size n, and in every index we can store up to 50 characters. And then I am creating another character array named order, which is the dishes consumed by the customer, and it is of size 1001. So now I am creating another integer array named total calories and number of items, both of size n. And in total calories, we will be storing the total calories consumed by every customer, and in number of items, we will store the dishes consumed by every customer. So first we have to accept the dishes consumed by the customer. So again, I am creating a for loop that iterates from 0 to n. And in every iteration, I am accepting the name of the customer and the order placed by the customer. So I am accepting two strings separated by a space. So the first string would be the name and the second string would be the order. So now soon after accepting our order, we are going to split that order, because the dishes consumed by the customer will be given as an input separated by comma. So we are going to split the string with comma and then find the dishes that is present in our character array food items to find its calories. So to do that, first I am creating two integer variables named dish calories and count. So the count is the number of dishes, and the dish calories will be the total calories consumed by every customer. So now we have to split the string order. So to do that, I am creating a new character pointer named dish, and I am using this function strtok, and then in the arguments I am passing the character array order and the argument comma. So whenever a comma is occurred in this string order, we will split it, and this while loop iterates until the token that is given by dish becomes null. And in every iteration we are also using this function strtok, and we are passing null in the arguments. So when we do like this, we will be able to iterate through all the dishes which are separated by a comma inside the character array order. So the current dish will now be stored in this pointer dish. Now we are going to check whether this pointer dish is present in our food items array. So to do that, I am creating a loop that iterates from 0 to f, because f is the number of food items available, and I am checking whether the dish is equal to any of the food item. So if this function returns 0, then we have found that particular dish, and the particular dish calories will be stored in the array calories. So I am adding dish calories with that calories. So like this, when we do this for every dish, after the execution of this for loop, we would have the total calories consumed by the customer. So I am storing the total calories into this array total calories, and then we are also incrementing the value of count in every iteration of this while loop. So the value of count will be the number of dishes consumed by the customer. So I am storing the value of count in number of items. So that is the number of dishes consumed by the customer. So now we have to sort the name of customers based upon the conditions given. To perform sort operation, we will be using bubble sort technique. In bubble sort, the first loop iterates from 0 to n minus 1, and the second loop iterates from 0 to n minus I minus 1. And we have to sort the name of customers based upon the total calories consumed. If the total calories consumed is equal, then we have to sort based upon the number of items. And only when the number of items are also equal, then we should sort based upon name. So totally we will be using three arrays. So the first array is total calories, and it is integer type, and the second array is number of items, it is also of integer, and the third array is names, so it is the character array. So whenever one condition is satisfied, we will swap all the arrays, only then we will get our desired output. So in every iteration of this loop, if the total calories of j is less than total calories of j plus 1, then we will swap all the arrays. So first I am swapping the total calories of j and the total calories of j plus 1, and then I am swapping total number of items of j and total number of items of j plus 1, and then I am swapping the names of j and j plus 1. And the first two functions is swap, because we are swapping integers, and the third function is swap ch. So this function swaps two character arrays. So we have already seen how these functions were implemented. So now the customer names would be sorted according to the total calories consumed by them in descending order. Since it is given descending order, we are using this less than symbol. And now if the total calories consumed by j is equal to total calories consumed by j plus 1, then we have to check for the total number of items consumed by them. So in else if condition, I am checking whether if total calories of j is equal to total calories of j plus 1. So if this condition is satisfied, then I am checking the total number of items consumed by j and total number of items consumed by j plus 1. So if j is less than j plus 1, then again we have to sort in descending order. So again I am swapping all the arrays. So first I am swapping total calories, and then I am swapping the number of items at j and j plus 1, and then I am swapping the names of j and j plus 1. And now if the total calories are equal and also the number of items consumed by both of them are also equal, then we should sort based upon their names. So in the else if condition, again I am checking whether if the number of items of J and number of items consumed by J plus 1 is also equal or not. So if this condition is true, then I am comparing the names of J and J plus 1. And the names should be sorted in ascending order. So in the string compare functions, I am comparing the name J and J plus 1, and here I am including greater than condition because the names must be sorted in ascending order. So again, if the names is greater than 0, then again I am swapping all the three arrays. So the total calories arrays, the number of items array, and J plus 1 name arrays. So when we perform sorting like this, the name of the customers will be sorted as per the condition given in the question. So after performing this swapping and sorting operation, finally I am creating a loop that iterates from 0 to n, and I am printing the name of the customers. So we will get our output as desired. Now let us check our program with sample test case. So now I have given the sample input 1, and this is our expected output. So we are also getting the same output. So the first customer name is MNO JKL, and then MNO JKL PQR, and then ABCDEFGHI. So ABCDEFGHI. So this is the logic behind today's daily challenge. Thank you for watching.